Welcome to 2 minute classes. We will discuss an example of nested if. Okay, so we are going to take forward the previous example and we are going to find the greatest among four entered numbers. Okay, so suppose I enter the four numbers as A, B, C and D. So I want to find greatest among them. Okay, so I am going to use nested if. You can do it with some other if statements also. Okay, so how I am going to proceed? I will compare A with B. If A is greater than B, if it is true, then I will compare A with C. If A is also greater than C, then I will compare A with D. And if that is also true, that means if this is true and this is also true, that means A is greater than B, A is greater than C and A is greater than D. So I will print A. So that is correct also. And if suppose A is greater than D is false. So that means the previous statements were true and only this statement was false. A was greater than B, A was greater than C, but A was not greater than D. So that means D is greatest. Okay, so because we have already compared A with B and C and it was greater, but it was not greater than D. So this is the if else which we have completed. Now we will come to this if. Okay, so if this if was true, then we are going to proceed it in this way. But if this if is false, that means if A is greater than B, yes, but A is not greater than C. Okay, then we have compared A with B and A with C, but we don't know anything about C and D. So over here we will compare C with D. That means A is not greater than C, then we will see whether C is greater than D or not. If C is greater than D, then I will print C, otherwise I will print D. Okay, so in this example it will work for A, B, C, D. Suppose these are four numbers. If A is greatest, then it will go in this way, A, this, this, and in this way it will print. If suppose C is greatest, so it will go in this way. This is true, this is not true, so this will go in this way. It will come here and it will print C. And if D is greatest, it can follow either of these two ways, if else. Okay, so these two will be true. A will be greater than B and C, and A will be less than D. In this way it will print D. Or there could also be a possibility that A is greater than B, but A is not greater than C, and C is also not greater than D. Then D will be printed. Okay. Now we will come to else of this if. Okay. So while writing nested if programs, you have to like dig down and then come outside. So I have completed this thing. I have completed this if. Now I will complete the else of this if. Okay. So this else means that B is greater. Then I will compare B with C and again B with D. If both of them are true, then I am going to print B. So we are just repeating this logic. And if like B is greater than C is true and B is greater than D is not true, then D is greatest. So this if else is completed. Then I will come to else of this if. In this I will compare. This else means B was greater than A, but B was not greater than C. B was not greater than C. So I will compare C with D. If that is true, then C is greatest, otherwise D is greatest. So these parts will be identical. Okay. So in this way we complete finding greatest of four numbers. We are gradually comparing each number with other, finding the greater of these two, then comparing it with C, then finding the greater and comparing it with D. So this completes the example of finding greatest of four numbers.